again. Don't know where, don't know when, but I know we'll meet again some sunny day. Keep smiling through, just like you always do, till the blue skies drive the dark clouds far away. So will you please say hello to the folks that I know? Tell them I won't be long. They'll be happy to know that as you saw me go, I was singing this song. We'll meet again, don't know where, don't know when, but I know we'll meet again some sunny day.
Friends, we come to farewell dear Mary Patricia Egelton. We come to mourn a relative, to honour a departed friend, and to show sympathy to the bereaved. Let's hear the words of our Lord Jesus. He says, I am the resurrection and the life. The one who believes in me will live, even though they die. And whoever lives by believing in me will never die. Let us pray. Eternal God, who destroyed death's power over us by your Son's death and resurrection, we remember Mary with love and thankfulness, and we pray that you will help us to be thankful for all that was good and praiseworthy in her life. God our Father, who in your compassion sent your Son into this world to suffer and to die for our salvation, we give thanks for his victory over sin on the cross at Calvary. We thank you for his triumph for us over death and for his resurrection, which has brought life and immortality to light for all who believe in his gospel. Grant to us the assurance that as Jesus rose from the dead and became the first fruits of those who died, so those who die in Christ will rise with him. And we give thanks that Jesus left us this prayer that we can pray together now. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. We have a Bible reading now from Psalm 23. Psalm 23. The Lord is my shepherd, I lack nothing. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside quiet waters. He refreshes my soul. He guides me along the right paths for his name's sake. Even though I walk through the darkest valley, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup overflows. Surely your goodness and love will follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. So Psalm 23 was written by King David about 3,000 years ago. He was the king of Israel, and it describes the Lord as a shepherd and us as his sheep. And the psalm explains how the Lord leads us to a better place. The psalm describes our relationship with the Lord as a personal relationship. The psalm says he's my shepherd and he's your shepherd. And the psalm describes how the Lord is like a shepherd who cares for his sheep, which is us. And he provides all that we need. Not necessarily all that we want, but definitely all we need. He provides refreshment for us, green pastures and still waters, blessings in our lives, and he even provides us with his holy word to give us instructions how to live a life that pleases him. But the Lord even leads us through dark valleys, difficult moments in our life, like Mari losing her sight, like a dark valley like today where we grieve the loss of a loved one. But this psalm is also about Jesus, because Jesus is described as the Good Shepherd in the Bible, and he came to earth 2,000 years ago to seek and save people lost from God, like lost sheep. He came to show lost sheep like us how they can come back to God and be found again. And not only did he look for lost sheep, but he was prepared to die for lost sheep. And he did this because we need to be fixed of our sin, as we mentioned earlier. He did this so that we could be right with God and live with him forever. And we can be right with God simply by believing that Jesus took away our sins. The destination point of the psalm is to allow us to live in the house of the Lord forever. That's the very last verse. The whole purpose of Jesus is to lead us to live with God in his house forever, in a forever place, a better place called heaven. And the Bible describes heaven as a place where there will be no more tears, no more crying, no more death, no more grieving or mourning or crying, no more weeks like the last few weeks, no more days like today, no more pain and suffering as Mari did. Instead, living in heaven with God forever, with peace and joy. That's where Mari is now. Her soul is there. Praise God. And I pray that we can all have comfort knowing these promises from God. So we now come to the committal, where we commit Mari's body back to our Creator God. Having given thanks for the life of dear Mari Patricia Egelton, we now commit her mortal body to the ground. Earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust, in the sure and certain hope of the resurrection to eternal life, through our Lord Jesus Christ, who died, was buried, and rose again for us. To him be the glory.
Leave a little room for God as you're going through the day. Leave a little room for God. You know He won't get in your way. Save a little place inside, somewhere you can call your own. And leave a little room for God. You won't ever be alone. Every day is so mysterious. You wonder how things came to be. And when you start to get real curious, well, He's the man you want to see. So leave a little room for God, just in case you need a friend. Everyone's got rainy days. It isn't so much if but when. Life is like a gift we're given. Every single day is new. We're thankful for the time we're living, but thankful exactly to who? Drive around a big old car. Leave a little room for God, or it won't take you very far. Yeah, leave a little room for God as you're going down the road. He'll not only point the way, He's gonna help you with the load. Above, that He'll be leaving room for you. He's always got some room for love. Leave room for God, my friend, and He'll have room for you. Just need to leave a little room for Him too.
Going through the day, leave a little room for God. You know He won't get in your way. Save a little place inside, somewhere you can call your own. And leave a little room for God, and you won't ever be alone. Every day is so mysterious. You wonder how things came to be. And when you start to get real curious, well, He's the man you want to see. So leave a little room for God, just in case you need a friend. Everyone's got rainy days. It isn't so much if but when. Life is like a gift we're given, and every single day is new. We're thankful for the time we're living, but thankful exactly to who? Come on now, put your money in the bank. Drive around a big old car. Just leave a little room for God, or it won't take you very far. Yeah, leave a little room for God as you're going down the road. He'll not only point the way, He's gonna help you with the thank your lucky stars above that he'll be leaving room for you. He's always got some room for love. Leave a little room for God, my friend, and he'll have room for you. Just need to leave a little room for him too.
Let me finish with this promise from God, from Isaiah chapter 41, verse 10. So do not fear, for I am with you. Do not be dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you and help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand. And now the blessing. The peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, may it guard your hearts and your mind. And the blessing of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you now and forevermore. Amen. Thank you.
Thank you, family and friends, for attending the service today for Mari. On behalf of Simplicity Funerals and the family, we'd like to thank you for your attendance today.
Thank you, Rosie. Thank you.